we're talking about digestion.
Every type of food we eat, fruit, vegetables, milk, grains, or meat, must be digested to provide
compounds we can utilize.
The digestive system does include specialized organs that process food. It contains, to be exact, accessory organs and the GI tract.
Let's see how those products move
through the digestive, the digestive tube.
Let's see how those products move
through the digestive, the digestive tube.
The first part we're gonna talk about is the oral cavity,
or the mouth.
It contains the tongue, 32 teeth, and saliva,
salivary gland secrete.
Yeah. Saliva, salivary gland secrete. Yeah.
The tongue and teeth initially digest the food
mechanically.
It's bitten, torn, ground and chewed, and saliva mixes in with the food.
Yeah. Saliva mixes in with the food. Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
Salivary amylase now starts to chemically digest complex carbs. So starch begins to get hydrolyzed
to maltose,
a disaccharide.
Yeah. There's no doubt, there's no question. We're talking about digestion,
ingestion, digestion, absorption, ingestion.
There's no doubt, there's no question. We're talking about digestion.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Digestion, yeah.
When the food is ground up thoroughly, a bolus forms. So now we'll be swallowed down the throat or pharynx as the epiglottis shields the larynx.
Peristalsis helps it move
down the esophagus, a hollow tube
that leads to the stomach, which over time turns the bolus into chyme.
Turns the bolus into chyme.
The stomach muscles now are used to mechanically digest the food.
It's mixed and churned
and combines with
hydrochloric acid and enzymes.
Chemical digestion now begins,
cause
the enzyme known as
aptopepsin
will enzymatically hydrolyze
proteins into large peptides.
Proteins into large peptides. Proteins into large peptides.
Bit by bit, the chyme then moves to the small intestine. That includes the duodenum.
Duodenum.
The jejunum.
Jejunum.
And the ileum.
The ileum.
Where the last phase of digestion's done.
There's no doubt, there's no question. We're talking about digestion.
Ingestion, digestion,
yeah.
Absorption, ingestion,
yeah.
We're talking about digestion, yeah.
The rush border
contains enzymes.
Yeah, yeah.
That digest nutrients in the chyme.
In the chyme.
But first they need a helping hand.
Need a helping hand.
From the nearby.
Woo! Nearby.
Accessory glands.
Yo, check it out.
The liver makes a substance called bile. The gallbladder stores some for a while, but they both release it at this time
to emulsify the fats
in chyme.
Yeah.
The pancreas will produce
and secrete pancreatic juice
to neutralize
the acid chyme
and digest it using
these enzymes.
Amylase, lipase, proteases.
Amylase split starches, which provide
maltose,
a disaccharide, so it completely carries out
what started earlier in the mouth.
Lipase splits fats, you may recall, to fatty acids and monoglycerol. Proteases split peptides, so we gain amino acids
and small peptide chains. There's no doubt, there's no question. We're talking about digestion.
Ingestion, digestion,
yeah.
Absorption, ingestion,
yeah.
Talk about the compounds.
The compounds that are very small
need no further digestion at all.
The larger nutrients in the chyme
are broken down
by brush border enzymes. The brush border contains enzymes.
Brush border.
The double sugars get hydrolyzed
to sugars
called monosaccharides. The peptides yield on hydrolysis
smaller peptides
and amino acids.
Break it down, break it down, break it down. Y'all, break it down, break it down,
break it down.
The digested nutrients now can be absorbed by the villi easily.
Yeah.
The non-digestible products move to the large intestine of the tube.
Yeah.
Let's see how those products move
through the digestive tube.
The colon contains several sites which absorb water and electrolytes.
Its
microbial flora,
by the way,
produce B vitamins and vitamin K. The residue left
from the chyme
is stored in the rectum till it's time for the anus
to
to eliminate the digestive and bacterial.